Greetings, my friends. I hope you are well, and I do hope that you have had a very successful academic year. I was with you just a couple of months ago, and since then, I went to Syria, and I told everybody about the wonderful time I had with you in your school. Marin Catholic High School has been on my mind a lot, and I think fondly of the time we spent together. Actually, you were one of the highlights of my trip to California last May. And I would like to thank you for listening to me, for your questions, your contributions, and allow me to thank the president and the staff and everybody who made my trip to your school such a wonderful experience, rich and deep and very touching and moving. So I'm here to tell you what happened after my trip to your school. I went to Syria, and the Awareness Foundation planned a training for young people to be ambassadors for peace. As you know, and as we talked when we met, Syria is still in a very, very ugly war. They have very little electricity, they have difficulty with water, and they have difficulty with transportation, with moving from place to place. Also, the safe areas are overcrowded with people, and a lot of needs are waiting to be filled. At the Awareness Foundation, we are trying our best to work, especially with young people like you. And because we believe that young people have the energy, they have the will, and they have the passion to change the environment around them, we are concentrating our work on working with young people and sending them out to be ambassadors for peace in their own communities in order to change the people around them and give them a positive message and encourage them to hold on to their values, to hold on to their love with each, to each other, their care for each other. Because in the time of war, one of the most difficult casualties of war is trust between people. And when the trust in the community breaks, then the community faces extinction, faces destruction. Because of that, we are trying to empower, trying to give a role, important role, to the young people in order to build their communities and heal the fractured trust in Syria. Because of that, thank you for your support. Thank you for having me and for listening to my message. And I'm conveying to you a message of love and gratitude from the young people in Syria, people like your age. And I'm very proud to wear today the t-shirt you gave me as a present. Thank you very much. I'm very proud of it, and I have it in the office, and I'm filming with it because I want to say thank you. Please keep your prayers for Syria and keep supporting us in order to support young people and support children in this desperate, desperate time for all of us there in the Middle East. God bless you, and please keep your support and keep your prayers for our work and for the country of Syria. Thank you very much. What can you do in this time? You are thousands of miles away from what is happening in the Middle East, and especially in Syria. You still can support. And you still can remember that when you grow up and you go out to your communities to work and build, that war is the worst thing that can happen to any country. And you need to remember always that the business of peace is always more profitable than the business of war to any community. Because of that, be agents of peace, be agents of trust, so that we protect our world and give it a better life than we have today. You can support us by your prayers, by talking about the problems in Syria, asking the difficult questions, and putting pressure on everybody in order to help the Syrians to come together in dialogue. And also, you can spare a little bit of money and collect this money to help young people like you in Syria. This summer, we are going to help hundreds of children, Syrian children, coming from all over Syria, flooding into Latakia, displaced children who are terribly disturbed by everything that they faced during the last couple of years. They are in trauma, they are in fear, in frustration, in anger, and we are going to help them to live as close as possible to a normal life. We are trying to empower them that when they go to school in September, they can go with a positive energy, that they can build new relationships, new friendships, and look at life in a more positive way. In order to do that, we're going to bring them into groups and camps and help them to relate to each other, talk to each other, read books and talk about what is happening and try to digest all that they are going through. At the end of the camp, we're going to give them a present of a rucksack that they can go to school and not ruin their books in winter with the rain, and also a water bottle that they can have water, because a lot of times the schools wouldn't have water and cannot have drinking water in schools. And also we will give them some stationaries for notebooks, pens, erasers and rulers and all this that they need for the next academic year. So your contribution will help us to bring all this stuff to the young people and to the children in order to prepare them for the next academic year. Thank you very much.